Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Mr. Lawson, and what we're going to do is a demonstration on offset angles. And what we're going to do is first start out with this introduction to the type of muds we use, which is straight flex. It's a sheetrock joint compound. Got it from 84 Lumber, as you can see, proud sponsor of 84 Lumber. And the reason why I use this type of mud is because it's green. And the green lid is actually has a glue in it, and it's used for texture and taping. So this is what we have. It's a straight flex from Menards, and this is the only place that you can get this type of material. And we use this on all the offset angles, which are not a 45. So what we're going to do is we're going to go all the way to the end here, and we're going to begin. This stuff is not easy to use. It takes time to learn how to use it. So what we're going to do is thick green mud, which is out of this bucket, not mixed, and a 4-inch knife, because the cardboard on this is very thick. So what we're going to do is get started on it. We're going to take and just go just like this. Make it real thick, put it on. And the thing you're going to want to know is the trick to the trade is always remember when you put this stuff on, you're going to wipe from the middle and go out from the middle. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So we put it on real thick, like I was saying. What we're going to do is now that I got it about the halfway point, we're going to begin to put the straight flex on. If you don't mind, my assistant Tim Roofer, can you give me a hammer and one nail? So now I'm going to take and put the straight flex on. I'm going to start it just like this.
Size nail and one.
Inch and 5/8 nail, please. Any nail will work. So what I'm going to do is bend this just like this. Not at a 45, just at an offset angle. And I'm going to take and put this on just like this. And the key to success on putting this stuff on and getting it to stay is taking and doing what I'm about ready to show you. I take my three fingers, which are these here, and I take and press just like this to get it to stay up there. If I don't stick this nail in here, it's going to end up making the whole thing fall. So I'm going to take and just spread this out from here using my three fingers, going all the way down here so that it falls equally with that wall angle. Then I'm going to take this here, my knife, and I'm going to begin right here. I'm going to do it just like this. So we're done on this end. Now we're going to work down this way. Make sure I don't run this whole wrong way. You'll lose your form if you do that. And I'm going to just push myself on.
come down. I'm going to keep going the same way that I've been doing it. Add in the mud. So I'm going to continue on down through here. I'm going to bend this straight flex again. Pull what I need over here. I'm going to form this back in here. I'm going to keep going with it. And we just keep going with it right down to here. We're almost at the end. But if we didn't put this nail in here, it would end up falling out. The stuff would fall to the ground and we'd be discouraged. So that's a trick of the trade. So I'm going to take and finish off all the way to the end. Once I get to the end, I'm going to take and cut it off. So I'm going to see where my end ends right here. I'm going to go with it. I just cut it with the razor.
taking form with my fingers one more time. Take the nail out, come through with my fingers. All of it is staying. I'm gonna go right here one more time to get it to form. Once we got it to form and it dries, we won't have no problems with this. One of the biggest problems with these offset angles is using the wrong tape. That's why we use the straight flat. And there you have it. Another lesson by Mr. Lawson.